In this part of the course, we will let the user create new text and open text files. Add a new item to the file menu and name it New. You can easily change the audio of such items. Also, we will add the Open button. Now double-click on New. We will need a string variable to store the current file name in it. Assign it an empty value. In the new click event, add a condition. If richttextbox contains text, then we'll warn the user about it and ask whether he wants to continue. If he hits the OK button, then the app will erase the text. In other words, that will be a new text. Also, we will erase the value of the current file variable. Now let's edit the open item click event. Put your code into the try-catch block to make sure that the app won't crash if there's a problem with the file. We will write a condition in the try part, but before that, add an open file dialog control to the form. I'll remove one from its name, since we'll use only one open file dialog. Go back to the condition. If dialog result period OK double equals open file dialog period show dialog brackets, then assign current file to open file dialog file name. And now we'll make conditions for file types, since richttextbox supports different formats. For this purpose, we need to add system period IO, that is input output, to the CS file of this form. You can write it manually at the top of your file or click a few buttons to let the Visual Studio edit for you. In different versions of Visual Studio, it is implemented in different ways. After that, write if path period get extension, in brackets write current file, double equals period txt, or if path get extension current file double equals period cs. Then call the richttextbox period load file method. In brackets, as the first argument you write current file, the second argument is how it should be opened. Write richttextbox stream type period plain text. Else richttextbox 1 period load file, in brackets write current file. This is loading file by default. We need it because by default richttextbox loads files as RTFs. Now let's add the file name to the window title. As you remember, I spoke about the try-catch block. They are always used together. Try is for action which is performed, and catch is for action which will be performed if the action in try caused errors. That's a good way to test your apps, since you can catch specific exceptions. If you need brief information, use the message property of the exception. Finally, let's test your text editor. I will try to open txt, cs, and rtf files. If you watch this, then you probably have already seen the previous part. If not, check it out. Also, if you are not familiar with Windows Forms, I recommend watching my introduction video. For those of you who are interested in more real-life examples, I suggest that you check out my login tutorials. The first one covers the simplest way of creating a login system. The second one is about using external files, such as text files and databases, for storing and retrieving passwords. But since I find it useful to combine all of the three ways, there is also a full login system tutorial video. In the next part, you will deal with saving files and closing your app. Thanks for watching.